Next we go to the percussion. Now percussion is a very important part of the examination, and it must be followed or carried out systematically. Now how you should be doing the percussion? I normally, whenever I meet my students, they describe it in a very haphazard manner and straightway start describing about the percussion note on both sides. So it is very important that when you want to do percussion, you are ideally doing this percussion on the lungs, and you want to diagnose whether the lung is afflicted with some pneumonia, fibrosis, or there is a fusion on that side. So it is first very important to mark the boundaries of the lung. Otherwise, suppose there is a volume loss, if there is a collapse, the diaphragm has gone up, the liver will go up on that side, then you will be only percussing on the liver and maybe falsely telling that the lower part of the lung is dull. So first and the foremost important thing on percussion would be outline the boundaries of the lungs. So you start from above downward and try to localize both diaphragms. So we know that the position of the diaphragm is different on left and right. So on one side you have the 6th, 8th and 10th position. On the other side you have a 5th, 7th and 9th intercostal spaces. So not only you try to see whether the diaphragms are normally placed, but you should also look for the movement of the diaphragm, and that you should do it by the tidal percussion. So if you are able to demonstrate the position of the diaphragm and the tidal percussion, then there is no disease around those diaphragm, around the diaphragm. So when there is an effusion, so how you localize the diaphragm on the right side? On the right side you start percussing from above downward, and because the lung is containing air, so the note will be resonant, and the moment you hit a dull note, that will indicate the presence of liver. So that's where you mark your diaphragm, and then you tell the patient to take a deep breath and again repeat it, and if you find the dullness has moved downwards by one space, that indicates a tidal percussion. Similarly, on the left side, when you move from above downward, you look for the instead of dullness, you look for a tympanic note of the stomach here, and that's how you mark the diaphragm. So by marking the position of the diaphragm, then you have actually found out the lung span. So that is the area of the lung span where you are going to percuss, or what we called as you are going to do comparative percussion. Comparative percussion is actually percussing over the